In this video, I'm going to go over atomic number, atomic mass, and mass number. So I'm going to go over the definitions of all three of these guys, where you're going to typically see them in your chemistry class, and then just some general facts you want to know about them. So let's start with atomic number. This is the most simple of the three. And so the definition of atomic number is just the number of protons in that atom. So that's the end. If you know how many protons you have in an atom, you know the atomic number. If you know the atomic number, you know how many protons are in that atom. And so another important thing about this is that every single atom of an element has the same number of protons. So let's take our example, carbon. Every atom of carbon has 6 protons. That's the atomic number of carbon. And so there is absolutely no such thing as a carbon atom anywhere in the universe with 5 or 7 protons. If it has that, it's not a carbon. But if you have 6 protons, 100%, you're a carbon. All right, and so the places you're gonna see atomic number, the big one is on the periodic table. And so your atomic number is how the periodic table is organized. If you look at it, you can see that going left to right, it increases in number, and that is the atomic number or the number of protons. And so if you ever look at a periodic table square and you see this integer number, your whole number, that is talking about the atomic number. That's how many protons that element has. And so another way you'll see atomic number is in this way that we can draw individual atoms, where you have the atomic symbol, that's the C, and then you have these two numbers stacked on top of each other, and your bottom one, this is also your atomic number. And so these two places are the most common places where you're going to see atomic number. All right, so now moving along right now to mass number, the definition of mass number is it's just the number of protons and neutrons added together in that one atom. So not just protons like atomic number, but now we're talking about both the protons and the neutrons. And so some facts about this, different atoms of the same element can have different numbers of neutrons. So let's go over where we can find these first. So first of all, mass number is not on the periodic table. That's an important fact. No periodic table anywhere is going to show you the mass number. We'll get into why in a second. And so the places you're gonna see mass number are gonna be in other problems and ways that your teacher is gonna show you. And so first of all, one of the ways you're gonna see it is back to this middle drawing. That top number, the one above the atomic number, this is the mass number. So anytime you see your atomic symbol and the two stacked numbers, the top one is always the mass number. And the other way you're going to typically see mass number is when you have your element name completely written out. This is a dash. It's not a negative sign. And then you're going to see this number right here. This is also your mass number. So 13 here and 12 here. These are your mass numbers. All right, so now let's talk a little bit more about mass number. So this is saying it's the general mass of an atom. And so if you're sitting there thinking, well, how could be the mass of an atom? Because I know that our atoms have protons and neutrons and electrons. Well, the answer is that the electrons are so small compared to the neutrons and protons that they just aren't added in the weight. We just say, okay, they're going to be so small, we don't really care. So a good comparison is that if you think of animals, a proton and neutron is like an elephant, an electron is like a chihuahua. So if you have a zoo and the zoo is just a bunch of elephants and chihuahuas, and someone says, we need to add up the entire mass of your zoo, you aren't going to care about measuring the chihuahuas. Who cares? They're so small. All we care about really is just measuring all the elephants and getting them on the scale, and then we're going to know the full mass. So that's what mass number is. Another important part about mass number is that different atoms of the same element can have different numbers of neutrons. So as we see here, we have something that says carbon 13, and we also have something that says carbon 12. Now these are two different atoms of carbon, which means they both are going to have 6 protons, because every atom of carbon always has 6 protons, because that's the atomic number, that's the definition. But they don't have to have the same number of neutrons, which means that the mass number doesn't have to be the same. So one carbon can have 6 protons and it has 7 neutrons, and then another carbon can have 6 protons and 6 neutrons. And just a general note, don't focus too hard on, well, why would one atom of carbon have 7 neutrons? Why would another have 6? It doesn't really matter so much for you. Just know that in general, it's usually similar numbers. It has to do with when the atom was formed. And so what happened when there was a star exploding or some super intense reaction that created this atom? It doesn't have to do with anything you're really going to be responsible for figuring out problems with. So just kind of accept that you know how many protons each atom is going to have, and then you're going to be told, or you can figure out how many neutrons that atom will have, but you don't have to know why it has that specific number. All right, so now with those two things, let's go ahead and go over atomic mass. So the definition of atomic mass is that it's the average mass of all the different isotopes for that element. And so let's define isotopes, and that is what we see down here with carbon. So when we have carbon 13 and we have carbon 12, these are two different isotopes, which means they have the same number of protons, they're both carbons, but they have different number of neutrons. And so when we take the average of all of them, then that's how we get to atomic mass. And so an important thing with atomic mass is that each isotope can have any percent as long as they all add up to 100%. So in the real world, carbon 13 is only about 1% of the carbons that exist in the universe, whereas carbon 12 is about 99% of the carbons that exist in the universe. So if you had a random carbon, the odds would be pretty good that it was a carbon 12. It's about 99% of carbons. And so what happens is we take an average of all of those isotopes, and then depending on what percent each isotope has, we average it in the correct way, and then we get to our atomic mass. And we see our atomic mass on the periodic table at the very bottom usually. So right here, in this case for carbon, it's 12.011. This is our atomic mass. And so it's usually a scraggly number because it's usually this average of all these different isotopes. And so I think that it can be hard at first to tell the difference between atomic mass and mass number. So here's something that I personally find useful. Let's look at a random family. You can pretend it's your family. And so let's say this family has 5 people in it. So think of how tall each individual person is as the mass number. So let's just say this person right here is 6 feet tall. And so we can see that in that family, there are some people that are taller than that person and some people that are shorter. And so the mass number, that's kind of like how tall one person is. And then the atomic mass, that would be the average of the entire family. So let's just say that the entire family is a little bit less than 6 feet tall. Maybe the average is 5 feet, 10 inches. So in this example, the average height would be the atomic mass. And so we really want to think about mass number. That's really one thing. Mass number, that's only ever talking about one atom. And that's why it's never on the periodic table, because a periodic table is trying to tell you about all the atoms that exist in the universe. And that's why atomic mass is, you should think about it as, it's never one thing. Atomic mass is this huge average of all the different atoms in the universe, and we've come up with this one scraggly number that will be the perfect average of all of them. And so just keep that in your head. Mass number, that's one thing, that's one atom, we have to be told it. Atomic mass, that's all the atoms in the universe, that's their average, and that's going to be on the periodic table. All right, I hope this was helpful for you guys. And as always, happy studying.
Hey, I hope you liked that video. Please feel free to subscribe, click around, and watch my other tutorials. And as always, happy studying.